Hello, Flanagan Falcons. Thank you for taking this opportunity to allow me to explain to you the JRTC program here at Flanagan. JRTC is a naval science program. My name is Commander Brian McDonald. I am the senior naval science instructor here, and my partner, Master Chief Patrick Peterson, we teach naval science. Now, some of you may have heard that ROTC is a lot like the military. Well, we do a lot of military things, but it's not just about the military. This program is based to bring out the leadership qualities in you and based on citizenship. Yes, you're going to learn about the Navy history and the significances of sea power, and you're going to learn about a lot about naval operations. But this is not about sitting at a desk and having a teacher just lecture to you. There's a lot of practical application that goes on in this class. For instance, if you wish to join the drill team, and that is a competition team, we get to go on field trips to within the state and compete against other schools. It's a great time. We also have academic competitions, and again, go on trips to compete against other schools. We also have robotics. We also have sea perch. Sea perch is like robotics underwater. We have the marksmanship team, which is air rifle. And if you're good enough and you can compete at the national level, you could possibly earn a scholarship. We also do orienteering, which is you put into a location at like a, say, a park, and you're given a map and a compass, and you do checkpoints. You find checkpoints throughout the course, and you have to do it under time. If you're good enough, you get to go to a national competition, which could be in Washington State or in Virginia. There's a lot of things that we do. We go on field trips. We go to the Coast Guard station down at Miami Beach and go on a Coast Guard cutter and see what life is like at a Coast Guard unit. We go to museums. There's a museum in Fort Lauderdale, the Navy Aviation Museum. We actually go to the SEAL Museum in Fort Pierce. There's a lot of things other than just putting on a uniform and doing military things. ROTC is so much more than that. So with that being said, I hope you give us the opportunity to sign up, try us out, see if you like it. I promise you, you won't regret it. Thank you for your time, and I hope to see you soon.
Hey, what's up, Flanagan? This is Dr. Ariano, chairperson for the Social Studies Department. Just want to talk a little bit briefly about some really cool electives that we have here in social studies that you might be interested in. And instead of looking elsewhere, you have it right here at Flanagan High School with some really cool social studies teachers. The first one is sociology. Sociology is the study of society and the way people behave, particularly how they behave in groups. Sociology, I understand, is offered elsewhere, but we offer it here at Flanagan. And so if you are interested in sociology, please find it in the course card. Please sign up for it. And it's a really cool class. And it's one of those classes that kind of gets you to see outside of what school is. The second one is law studies. Law studies has been offered on and off the last few years. It's going to be on for next year. Those of you interested in a legal career or might be interested in pre-law in college, this is one of those courses that kind of gives you a taste of what pre-law is and what legal studies looks like. So law studies is also available for you. Law studies is available at any grade, right? It's available for 10th graders, 11th graders, and 12th graders. And so if you're really interested in that kind of stuff, if you think about, if you like lawyering, if you like political science, government, those are kind of the things that you would be looking at in law studies. And lastly, another class that wasn't offered last year, but we hope to have it this year, is AP European History. For those of you that are part and understand the AP program is the advanced program that we have here at Flanagan. We have AP World History, we have AP US History, AP Government, and now we have AP European History. So if you're interested in a more condensed version of world history, just focusing strictly on the history of the European continent, AP European History is for you. You can receive college credit with that AP European History class if you do well on the exam at the end of the year. And I just want to make sure that you guys get into it. So thanks for listening. I hope to see you there. And if you have any questions about any of these classes, I won't tell you the room. Let me give you the email better. You can always email me, Dr. Ariano, or talk to your guidance counselor about trying to sign up for these electives. All right. Till then, have a wonderful 2021 rest of the school year. Peace.
Hi, I'm Ms. Kelly, and I'd like to talk to you about a couple of electives that are available for you to take next year. The first one is AP Psychology. AP Psychology is a college credit class. We take a look at different aspects of psychology. It's the study of the mind and human behavior. So we take a look at memory. How does memory work? What can we do to boost our memory? What are little tricks we can use to help us remember our class material? We study the psychological disorders and the treatments. We also study the brain, a slew of different chapters. We do cover the whole book. And in May, you do take a College Board test. If you pass the College Board test with a 3, 4, or 5, that is considered passing the test and you receive a college credit. This will help save money because this is a class you do not have to pay when you go to college. And also you do not have to buy the book. So that's more money in your pocket. So you will leave high school with actual college credit. The other class I would like to talk to you about is sociology. So psychology is the study of the individual. Sociology, which is an honors class, is the study of society. So we take a look at culture. How has culture affected you and your development? What about your family, socialization? How are boys and girls socialized differently when we're raised, and how does that affect us as adults? So we take a look at religion, a slew of different chapters in that class also. Please feel free to reach out to your guidance counselor. Please swing by if you're here on campus, and you can speak with Ms. Pitty or myself. Ms. Pitty's in room 233. I'm in room 232. We'll be happy to answer any questions for you. But also reach out to any of your friends, see if they're taking any of the classes, and see what they have to say about the class. Thank you. I'm Ms. Kelly.
And I'm Coach Carter.
And we're going to talk to you about dual enrollment. Dual enrollment is a Broward College course that is offered here at Flanagan for free. I teach developmental psych, which is known as from the womb to the tomb. We take a look at the development over life from conception to death.
I teach HLP 1081. It's total wellness. It's all of the dimensions of wellness. So many people think if they ask you, how are you, and you say, I'm well, it's physical wellness. There's emotional wellness, spiritual wellness, financial wellness, all different types, mental wellness of wellness. Very interesting course as well.
Broward College is offered here for free, so you don't have to pay for your class, you don't have to pay for your book, so that is money in your pocket. You also only meet twice a week. There's no classes on Fridays.
This is the greatest opportunity if you qualify. You only need a 3.0 to qualify. Like Ms. Kelly said, the flexibility is great. We finish 4 to 5 weeks before school ends, so you have time to study for your AP exams, time to study for your final exams. You have no class for the last 5 weeks because we work on Broward College's calendar, not Flanagan's calendar.
If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to your guidance counselor. If you're here on campus, please feel free to stop by, see me. I'm in room 232.
I'm in room 904, and please ask your friends. We've had so many kids in this school. Ask around. We've probably had brothers and sisters, cousins, friends, neighbors. Ask them about dual enrollment. It's a perfect pairing. We both use the same system. Everything's the same. You come from my class, go to Ms. Kelly's class, and you have two classes in one period. That's the big advantage, is you're getting an extra A 6.0. An A in dual enrollment is worth a 6.0. You're getting that extra class. Where everybody else has 8 classes, you have 9 classes. It's not an additional class, but within one period, it is an additional class because we leave halfway through.
So you're leaving high school with college credit. So that's less time that you have to spend actually in college when you think about it. So think about it, talk to your friends. Please feel free to reach out to us for guidance, and we hope to see you in class.
Okay, see you soon.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Hello everybody, I wanted to welcome you to an elective here at Flanagan High School called Creative Writing. This is a perfect elective for any students who love writing in the creative sense, right? So if you like writing children's books or short stories or parodies or odes or spoken word, science fiction, the list goes on and on what we do in this classroom. It's a creative space. If I don't hit a topic or a genre that you wanted to talk about, I'm very open to suggestions, so feel free to just you know, ask about it and I'll work it into a lesson somehow. I want every writer to come out of this classroom feeling like they grew as a writer and as a student. I know I've had students leave here already having been a published author because of what we did in our class, and they took it to that next level, and that's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping to make you fall in love with writing all over again, because this isn't like an essay writing class, it's a creative writing class. So ideally you should come here and you would want to write because it's fun and it's a safe space and you get to explore your mind and put it all on paper, and we share it and we give feedback. And honestly, this class, to me, we become like one big happy family because we end up sharing and communicating and giving feedback, like I said, which is so important to your growth as a writer and a student. And I believe you also leave this class becoming more open-minded, more open to new perspectives, more willing to explore other perspectives. And that's just another added benefit to this class. So if you love writing, then I'm the teacher and this is the course for you. I hope you take it. I hope I see you next year. So that's creative writing. And my name is Kristy Modia, KRISTY.Modia@BrowardSchools.com. Feel free to email me with any questions. And that's it. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Hi, Falcon family. My name is Mrs. Bolger. I'm the health science teacher here at Flanagan High School. The health science program at Flanagan High School is designed for students who have a genuine interest in pursuing a medical career. I personally am a registered nurse. That is my background. To get into the health science program, the student must have at least a 3.0 unweighted GPA, good attendance, and a strong willingness to learn. The program consists of three levels. Sophomore year, students will take Health Science 1, which is an anatomy, physiology, medical terminology, pathophysiology course. Health Science Foundations is a junior level course that will go over basics of healthcare, such as legal ethical issues, infection control. We do CPR, vital signs, etc. The third level course is a double block, and this is the level in which students will obtain industry certifications. They will be eligible to take the EKG certification course, as well as the Certified Medical Administrative Assistant certification. In addition, students can join HOSA, that's the extracurricular club that goes along with the program, and students are strongly encouraged to participate as they will gain leadership skills and opportunities for service hours. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me, and I look forward to seeing you in class. Thank you.
So, hello incoming Falcons. My name is Brittany Lynch, and I am this year's editor-in-chief for yearbook. This school year is definitely different than anything we've ever experienced in the past, but that doesn't change our mission, which is to create a book that fully captures our school and the interesting year ahead of us. And next I'll have speaking is our other editor-in-chief, Jelena Laws.
Hi everyone, yes, I'm Jelena Laws, a co-editor-in-chief. And as Benny said, this year has brought a lot of change, but this change has given us an opportunity to create a people-centered book. About the people, for the people, and by the people.
So what that means is that we'll be extending our staff, and it's just going to be beyond just the people who are in yearbook. It's open to everyone and anyone, artists, photographers, anyone who's willing to contribute and cooperate with us to make a wonderful book this year.
Yes, so please scan the QR code and fill out the survey so we can get to know a little bit more about our incoming freshman class. We look forward to working with you.
Yes, so thank you, and please look out for your book. And at the end of the year, please buy our book. So thank you.
Thank you. Enjoy the year.
Hi everyone, my name is Tiana, and I took ENC 1101 and ENC 1102 this year. By taking these courses, I was able to earn college credits, get a head start on the college experience, and raise my GPA and ranking. ENC 1101 and ENC 1102 are dual enrollment courses. meaning that they are Broward College classes that are offered to high school students. You can sign up for ENC 1101 and 1102 by writing the names of these courses on your dual enrollment recommendation form after receiving a passing score on the PERT or ACCUPLACER. Overall, I am very grateful to have had the opportunity to take these courses this year, and I strongly recommend you do as well.
Hi everyone, my name is Lexi and I'm president of Flanagan High School Student Government Association, also known as SGA. SGA specializes in a bunch of school-wide projects and activities. Some of our projects deal with health and safety, community service, and school spirit. We also plan big projects like homecoming. SGA is an amazing club for anybody who's interested in getting involved. If you are interested in joining the SGA class, an application is required. For more information about the release of our application, please follow us on Instagram at FHS_SGA. Remember, if you are interested in joining the SGA class, you must submit an application and complete an interview. If you have any questions at all, please DM us on Instagram at FHS_SGA, and I hope to see you soon.
Hi, incoming juniors. I know selecting your classes for this year is honestly kind of hard because, you know, you don't want to choose classes that are going to be too much for you and leave you struggling, but this is the year that colleges are looking at, so you still want to continue to challenge yourself and not to be content, you know? And for this reason, I am honestly encouraging you to take AP English Composition because the class is amazing and Ms. Shahande is an amazing teacher. She is extremely helpful, and if you don't understand anything, she will explain it 10 times over if she has to.
This class forces you to have deep conversations and to analyze situations from your point of view and from others, and it helps you develop perspectives on universal topics, which in return increases your conversational skills, and it also helps increase your reading and writing skills. You know, for me personally, I have began to write essays about 5 times as fast, and I breeze the documents in other classes, and this class has helped me in more ways than just English. It has helped me develop ideas and perspectives on the world.
Hello, I'm Mr. Nesaroff. I teach AP Comparative Government. Now, despite what the name of the course would imply, which honestly sounds kind of boring, it is not. It's actually a really interesting course. In AP Comparative Government, our curriculum involves 6 countries in the world: Britain, Russia, China, Iran, Nigeria, and Mexico, and we include the United States as well. And we look at how those countries operate. We look at their present-day governments, societies, and how it affects their present-day governments. And then, of course, like the name of the course would imply, we do compare them. We answer things like, why are they so poor in this country? Or why was this country successful? Or why is this country an authoritarian government, not a democratic government? And honestly, they're pretty interesting questions. The curriculum involves looking at those countries. We have a textbook, which is online. There's a unit test, which has writing for each country. We also have 2 reading quizzes and a terms quiz. The other thing that we do for a grade is news analysis. So since all of these countries are in the news pretty frequently, more so than most other countries. We look at articles from the New York Times and see how they relate to our curriculum as well and discuss them in class. Most of the classes are lecture classes. I will lecture about the history of the country, its political institutions, how people participate in government, what kind of culture they have, and the tests are mainly from that. So if you're looking for a course that is interesting, also satisfies a requirement, either your semester of U.S. government or your semester of economics, then this is the class to take. Thanks. Look forward to seeing you.
Hi, I'm Mr. Torres, and I would like to talk to you about the Aerospace Tech 2 Honors Remote Pilot Operations class that is offered here at the school. If you are interested in aviation, if you are fascinated by the science of aerodynamics and what keeps planes up in the sky, you'll find the class fascinating. In addition to that, we're going to learn about the Code of Federal Regulations required to pass the FAA Part 107 commercial drone pilot license. So by the end of the class, you will have your airman's license to be a certified unmanned aircraft pilot. So if you're interested in any of those subjects, if you are curious about the class, please feel free to shoot me an email. You can find my contact information on the school website. Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll try to help you out. All right, so if you have any questions, please contact me. It's a fascinating class and a great experience to anyone that's interested in aviation. So let me know. That's Mr. Torres, and you can find my information on the school website.
Flanagan has always had a coveted history as a school with an exceptional music program, and this year will be no different. We have one of the most comprehensive band programs in the state of Florida, with something to offer for everyone. For students with experience in band and orchestra, we have three different levels of concert bands. Top concert ensemble, the Flanagan Wind Orchestra, is a regular headliner at state and national performance festivals, most recently being invited to perform at the Grand National Adjudicators Invitational in Atlanta, Georgia. For those students who may not have been able to join music in middle school but are interested now, we offer beginning band and beginning drum classes for eager students. We also offer two levels of jazz bands here at Flanagan, which you'll regularly see performing around school and around the community. The Dance and Color Guard program here at Flanagan High School is second to none and is one of the most respected programs in the entire country. Our top winter guard has been a World Guard International finalist every year for the past 12 consecutive years and has been a two-time world champion. Our top guard went undefeated all last season, and our intermediate guard was a medalist for the entire season. All of these components come together in the fall semester as part of our Falcon Sound Marching Band. This ensemble of over 130 students, more than 25 staff members, and an army of parent volunteers is the crown jewel of our program, consistently earning straight superior ratings and traveling across the country and across the state of Florida to perform. Students in our program learn teamwork, discipline, and are expected to excel in their academics. Our student-led program focuses on student leadership and attends to the individual needs of every student. There's a place for everyone in our Falcon Sound family, and we hope that you'll join us.
Hi, my name is Chanel Vamis, and I'm the president of Peer Counseling.
Hi everybody, my name is Sage Gordon. I'm the Vice President of the Peer Counseling Club here at Flanagan.
My name is Elizabeth Seuss and I am the Treasurer of Peer Counseling.
Hello, I'm Maya Ramsey and I'm the Secretary of Peer Counseling.
Hi, I'm Sienna and I'm the Historian of the Peer Counseling Club.
Peer Counseling at Flanagan High School is a course that consists of just three levels. Each level, the student will progress from the training and learn how to help those in need. The class is not formally run like a class, but more like a club. We help create activities not only for the class, but throughout the school. Therefore, students will have multiple opportunities and to enhance their skills and come out of their comfort zone and have a more sense of unity here.
The benefits that one can earn from taking this course are mentoring skills, developing new skills, new bonds with students, kindness and acceptance, mentoring, counseling, active listening, and then confidential support, and so much more.
Furthermore, peer counseling will help students prepare for the real world. The communication and active listening skills students will gain from the class will help them in any occasion, especially serious situations. Our students and their mental health comes first. And peer counselors will try to make you feel a sign of relief by becoming the listening ears some students aren't able to have.
And the goal of this course is to provide a sense of unity in the class and throughout the school. Students will undergo their training and lots of team bonding activities while in the club. Students will also be presented with lots of activities and events they will be able to participate in to gain community service hours. Community service hours are a graduation requirement here at Flanagan.
We hope that you consider peer counseling as your elective for next year. It's super fun and it'll become a big part of your high school life and you'll enjoy every second of it.
Hi, this is Mrs. Hermosilla, and I would like to share with you what's available at the Flanagan High School Math Department for our students. Our courses provide students with the opportunity to improve their computation and critical thinking skills. These are skills necessary for success in college and in later career goals. Our courses start from Algebra 1 and go all the way to AP Stats and Calculus. Student success is built upon by providing challenging and real-world problems for our students to solve and analyze. Remember, these are necessary skills for success in college and in a fast-paced work environment. Like reading, math skills are useful throughout your life.
Hello there. Are you interested in digital technology? Are you curious about the way computers work? Would you like to learn more about how they operate more than just desktop applications? Are you curious in becoming more than just a user and would like to become a developer of digital technology? If you are, then you might want to look into some of the classes that we offer here at the school in the subjects of information technology and computer science. You can start off with advanced IT honors, where we will learn about the basics of computer science and information technology, and we'll start building apps using the Python programming language. If you're interested in a little more challenge, and if you are curious about advanced placement classes, you can go to the next level, which is the AP Computer Science Principles class, where we're going to use the JavaScript programming language to develop a performance task application for the College Board and learn about the AP Computer Science Principles multiple choice exam. It's a great opportunity. It's a college level class, and it's a good introduction to AP overall. In addition to just learning about programming languages, we're going to learn more about the impact on society and about the internet and other topics as well. If you're up for the top challenge, that would be the AP Computer Science A class, where we're going to learn the Java programming language, and we'll learn more about encapsulation and the object-oriented programming required to pass the AP Computer Science A course. So it's three different levels. If you're interested in learning how to write computer code with programming languages, Python in advanced IT honors, JavaScript in computer science principles, and Java in computer science A. So if you would like to learn more, you are more than welcome to contact me. I'm Mr. Torres. You can find my information on the school's website. I would love to hear from you. And I am excited to guide anyone on their path to any kind of career in computer science or information technology. All right, I look forward to hearing from you.
Hello students, my name is Ms. Dominguez and I am the UTAP teacher. If you don't know what UTAP stands for, it's Urban Teacher Academy Program. So essentially what this program is if you're interested in working with kids, if you're interested in being a teacher someday, and if you just want to create that family environment, club feel, this is the perfect club for you or the perfect class for you, because this is a very family-oriented elective. And if that is something that interests you, I would love for you to join and participate out of all the amazing activities that we have, especially in store for this new upcoming school year. And now a message from our president and vice president. So check it out.
Hey guys, my name is Gabby Rivera and I'm the president of UTAP. I just wanted to pop in here to give you some information about our class and a club so you guys know what we do, and just to interest you to get you to join our class and honestly, I think you would love it if you did. So let me actually get into it. So I know that when you see Urban Teacher Academy program, you're thinking, oh, I can't be in this class because I probably don't want to be a teacher. If you do want to be a teacher, great, amazing. Honestly, this class will like get you to a point where you already think that you're a teacher and you're like, oh my god, I know everything. But yeah, like you don't have to want to be a teacher to be in this class. You honestly gain so many skills by just being in this class, like leadership skills, communication skills, team building skills, which are all things that you're going to need in the future. So I definitely recommend this class for those things as well. And honestly, if you want to be like a teacher or anything involving education or with kids, this class is like perfect for you to take. Another thing about our class is that we are really family oriented. So we all basically know each other. We're all like a little family and we're always communicating with each other, which is what gets you to that like amazing communication. But yeah, which is something that you always need when you're in a class or club. Honestly, this class has taught me so much and it's helped me just gain so much confidence when talking and just with everything, basically, like literally everything. So I definitely recommend this class. Made me come out of my shell so much and I am so thankful. So I think that this class would be perfect for anyone who has like little shy problems or like if you have anxiety like I do, I recommend. I wanted to show you guys a little bit of some things that we like to do. Like we like to incorporate activities and stuff with elementary schoolers because we do go off campus and visit the elementary schoolers, teach them, do in-class teaching and one-on-one teaching with the kids. This is kindergarten all the way to third grade, by the way. So this is one of the little things that we did last year. This is one of the activities that I organized for the kids to do. These are just little thank you notes that they did for Valentine's Day. We also have this vision board that we like to do. Also these little Thanksgiving activities and these little cute little notes right here. Also right here, you can't really see, but that's trunk or treat, which is another amazing activity that we do. So I definitely recommend this class if you want to do a bunch of things, if you want to actually be a teacher, you know, this class is perfect for that. If you just want to come out of your shell and get to know other kids from every other grade, because we have like every single grade in this club, and you know, you'll just be accepted, you'll be loved. So I definitely recommend taking this class. And now our vice presidents are going to speak and tell you a little bit more.
I'm Emily and I'm the vice president of UTAP. So as you've heard multiple times now, UTAP is a program where we volunteer with the elementary school kids and with our high school student or with high school students. But for me, what UTAP is about is truly the connections I make with both the kids and my peers. So I just wanted to show you quickly some of the things we've done in UTAP and some of the gifts I've gotten just to show you guys what it's all about. First of all, I've made vision boards like this one. We also had an activity where we had to make children's books, and I have both of them from two different years. This one called The Lost Ticket and Crispy Saves the Day. These two books that we made were great, fun activities that we had to do that honestly helped us all bond. These are some gifts that were given to me by my little mentees at the elementary schools. They both were drawn for me. And then also, this is a letter that was given to me by a senior. I mean, last year when I was a junior, this was a letter given to me by a senior. So I just wanted to show you guys some of the things that UTAP is about. Hopefully it helps show you guys to join UTAP, because honestly, this program has changed my life for the better and it makes me so happy every day to be able to say that I'm in UTAP.